Cat Dog Nürburg is Cat's personal hell creepypasta. When Cat was alive, he was a human. He was very smart, withdrawn and overly critical, possibly the result of autism or even Asperger's. Yours truly is high-functioning autistic. He had a twin brother, but whereas Cat, henceforth referred to as Kent, was hyper-intelligent and neurotic, his twin dog, henceforth referred to as Doug, was actually developmentally disabled. Also, remember that the quoted statements refer directly to Cat/Kent's personal views and opinions and do not reflect my own. Despite Kent's self-proclaimed superiority, these views were not held by everyone else in his life, including his parents, whose lack of respect, as Kent saw it, he saw as a personal insult, made doubly so by the fact that they showed the same level of respect and love, no more or less than a parent would show a child, to Kent's inferior brother. To Kent, his life is hell. His parents don't understand him and don't bow to his superior intellect. And his classmates are even worse. So, when he is accepted into an Ivy League school, he finally sees the chance to surround himself with intellectual equals. So of course distancing himself from his unintelligent parents and defective brother. He quickly finds his new life everything he wanted, at least more so than before. Granted, he still had to deal with inferiors who Kent believes do not know their place. After graduation, he accepts a dream job in the field of his choice. He's engaged to be married. He doesn't bother inviting his family. But when his parents die in a car crash, it becomes his job to deal with his brother who cannot live on his own and cannot be put in some kind of assisted living facility for the mentally handicapped, since his job hasn't yet turned itself into the lucrative career he figured he might have. Combined with already strained financial burdens and personal strain, Kent and his wife divorce. Kent and Doug are left together. Taking care of Doug begins to be a full-time burden, with Kent's job performance suffering as a result. After his termination, Kent's attitude and ego make employment difficult, and Doug makes Kent's trials even more tribulating. With no hope for the future, Kent contemplates the unspeakable, murdering Doug. While bathing Doug, Kent looks into his brother's eyes, give him a warm smile, for Kent at least, and pushes his brother under the water, holding him until the bubbles stop. But when the other people in Kent and Doug's life get suspicious, the truth comes out. When the cops come, Kent makes a break for it. It's not fair, he thought. I deserve better, he thought. I have rights, he thought. They should revere me, he thought. How dare they treat me this way, he thought. I'm practically their god, he thought. Crash. In his mania he nearly missed oncoming traffic, but not the side of the bridge, as he drove off of it. He tried to get the belt off. It's safe to say he didn't survive. Doug was already buried by the time Kent was interred into his family's plot. No one mourned him. In Nürburg, Kent is a cat, which he reviled in life due to their habit of breeding mental illness. Also, as a cat, Cat/Kent has an aversion to water, since Kent drowned. Dog is a manifestation of Kent's brother, Doug, taking the form of a dog, since Kent and Doug were exact opposite. The Greasers, aside from being similar to Cerberus, are obviously inspired by the various bullies Kent dealt with in life, taking the form of dogs to illustrate how much he differs from them. Cat dog's parents are never seen, since in life he wanted nothing to do with them, and now that he might need the comfort that he took for granted, the absence of Cat-Dog's parents are a metaphor for the fact that Kent will never feel comforted in hell. Winslow is a mouse, since Kent considered himself superior to others, like how cats are higher up on the food chain than mice. He's also a smartass due to the fact that Kent's inferiors always mocked him. Lola is a bird, for similar reasons to Winslow. And the fact that her intelligence gets her respect and admiration, while Kat's gets him nothing, is based on how Kent often felt overshadowed, either by those who were inferior but still beat him, or by those who either matched, or even on rare occasions succeeded, Kent's prowess. This is to illustrate that even in his personal hell, intellectual prowess means something, but Kent's means nothing, which is meant to be, in Kent's eyes, the greatest insult possible. Any attempts to gain any financial and or career gain always fail, since in life Kent had to abandon such things to care for his brother. Any attempts at any success are thwarted, since he lives in hell, and that the whole point is to show the meaninglessness of Kent's views and beliefs. The overall cartoony nature of the series is basically inspired by the insipid cartoons that Doug loved that Kent despised. Rancid Rabbit is always the authority figure for two reasons. For one, he's pretty much Satan, if not just a proxy. He keeps Cat-Dog in their place, because it's hell. For another, as an authority figure, Rancid is a metaphor for the parents that didn't give him the respect and admiration he wanted. The teachers that try to keep his attitude in check. The various authority figures who had authority Kent felt was lesser than his own. Cat-Dog hardly ever suffers as a whole. Usually, either Cat suffers alone, receiving the brunt of the greaser's bullying, being victimized by Rancid Rabbit's schemes to the greater degree, or Dog suffers, but the suffering that Cat feels is basically, in Cat's eyes, worse, also a metaphor for Cat's selfishness.